Hello, Christ is in our midst. I'm Father Kevin Long of St. Elias, St. Joachim Orthodox Church in Newcastle, Pennsylvania. Today is Wednesday, September 8th, the day that we remember the Nativity of the Mother of God. And here are the readings for today, in this year 2021. The first reading is from St. Paul's letter to the Philippians, chapter 2, verses 5 through 11. Brethren, have this mind among yourselves, which is yours in Christ Jesus, who, though he was in the form of God, did not count equality with God a thing to be grasped, but emptied himself, taking the form of a servant, being born in the likeness of men. And being found in human form, he humbled himself and became obedient unto death, even to death on a cross. Therefore God has highly exalted him and bestowed on him the name which is above every name, that at the name of Jesus every knee should bow, in heaven and on earth and under the earth, and every tongue confess that Jesus Christ is Lord, to the glory of God the Father. Amen. And today's Gospel reading is from the Gospel of St. Luke, chapter 10, verses 38 through 42, chapter 11, verses 27 and 28. At that time Jesus entered a village, and a woman called Martha received him into her house. And she had a sister called Mary, who sat at the Lord's feet and listened to his teaching. But Martha was distracted with much serving, and she went to him and said, Lord, do you not care that my sister has left me to serve you alone? Tell her then to help me. But the Lord answered her, Martha, Martha, you are anxious and troubled about many things. One thing is needful. Mary has chosen the good portion which shall not be taken away from her. And as he said this, a woman in the crowd raised her voice and said to him, Blessed is the womb that bore you and the breast that you sucked. But he said, Blessed rather are those who hear the word of God and keep it. Glory to thee, our God. Glory to thee. Continuing on, in our reading of The Way of the Ascetics by Teacher Colliander, we go to chapter 8, which is on the guarding against the entry of the vanquished evil. The first time you are victorious over yourself may be assigned to you. Now I am on the way. But do not consider yourself virtuous. Only thank God, for it was he who gave you the power. And do not rejoice beyond measure, but go swiftly on. Otherwise, the vanquished evil may come to life and conquer you from the rear. Remember that Israelites received the command from God to drive out all the inhabitants of the land when they conquered the new land. See Numbers 33:52 and following. In order that we might learn from them, the degree of victory over self is of trifling importance. It consisted, perhaps, in our skipping our morning cigarette, only in such an apparent unimportant thing as not turning our head or refraining from meeting at a glance. The externally noticeable happening is not the decisive one. The little thing can be big and the big little, but always in the next phase of the battle, it is waiting. We must be constantly prepared. There's no time to rest. Once again, be silent. Let no one notice what you are about. You are working for the invisible one. Let your work also be invisible. If you scatter crumbs around you, they are willingly picked up by birds sent by the devil. The saints explain, beware of self-satisfaction. In one mouthful, it can devour the fruit of much toil. Therefore, the Father's counsel, act with discernment. If two evils, choose the lesser. If you are in private, take the poorest morsel. But if anyone is looking, you should take the middle way that arouses the least notice. Keep hidden as the inconspicuous as possible. In all circumstances, let this be your rule. Do not talk about yourself, or about how you slept, or what you dreamed, or what happened to you. Do not state your views unasked, and do not touch upon your wants and concerns. All such talk only nourishes your self-preoccupation. Do not change your work, your residence, and the like. Remember, there is no place, no community, no external circumstance that is not serviceable for the battle which you have chosen. The exception is only such works as directly serves your vices. Do not seek higher posts and higher titles. The lower the position of service that you have, the freer you are. Be satisfied with the living conditions you now have, and do not prompt to show your learning or your skill. Hold back your remarks. No, it isn't so-and-so, but so-and-so. Contradict nobody, and do not get into the arguments. Let the other person always be right. Never set your own will above that of your neighbor. This teaches you the difficult art of submission. Along with it, humility. Humility is indispensable. Take remarks without grumbling and be thankful when you have scorned, disregarded, or ignored. But do not create humbling situations. They are provided in the course of the day as richly as you need. We notice the person who is forever bowing and fussily servile and perhaps say how humble he is, but the truly humble person escapes notice. The world does not know him. See 1 John chapter 3, verse 1. For the world, he is mostly zero, or really in today's word, he's canceled. When Peter and Andrew, John and James, left their nets and followed him, see Matthew 4:20, what did their fellow workers say who were left on the shore? For them, the two pairs of brothers vanished and they were gone. Do not be hesitant. Do not be afraid of disappearing like them, for this adulterous and sinful generation. What are you hoping to win, the world or your soul? Woe to you when men shall all speak worthy of you. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, one God. Amen. Have a great day. God bless you, and God willing, we'll see you tomorrow.